Hey guys, welcome to my channel DevTech Finance. I am Nisha and I am here with another video of mine on financial market. It is quite an interesting topic and I hope you all would like to study to know about this. The agenda for this video of ours would be the introduction to financial market. We would be covering the types of financial market, where in details we would talk about the money market and the various instruments involved in money market, like the call money, the commercial papers, the treasury bills and the certificate of deposits. Moving on to our first content slide, that is the introduction to financial market. I would like to explain it in a manner like, what do you understand by market? Market is any place to facilitate exchange. Whether you want to buy something, whether you want to sell something, you are having a common denomination of money for that, which is facilitating that exchange process. So financial market is very similar. Financial market, here you are involved in trading of financial assets, like the equities, the bonds, the currencies. You are exchanging these things to earn some profit out of it, to gain some value out of it. Financial market helps in establishing the price of financial assets. So as you know, there are various financial assets and all are having their own price. How this price is determined? This price is determined by the presence of the forces of demand and supply. You must have read in economics also, like the demand and the supply forces gives a rise to the price determination of that particular product in the market. So in the same way, in financial market, investors are there, then at the same time, borrowers are there who are involved in the selling and buying of those financial assets, and that gives a rise to the price determination. It provides liquidity to financial assets as they could be negotiated and transferred. So you must have heard, like, I am selling my share, or I wanted to buy that share, or I am selling this bond, I wanted to buy this after a certain time period. So what does this show? It shows like these instruments are negotiable, these instruments are transferable. You can transfer it from one person to another at different time horizons, whenever you feel like, whatever is the maturity period of the related financial assets. It could be shorter time period, it could be longer time period. It helps you in saving the cost of transactions. So cost of transaction involves various costs, like the cost in searching for that asset, in gathering information about that assets, the time involved in locating the customer. Just think of it. Now you want to buy any product. You just go to the shop and you know that the product would be available there. You just purchase it out from there. But what if there is no presence of the market? There are no shops which you are aware of. What you would do? You would search for that product which you wanted to purchase. You would search for the shop where you can get that from. It would involve a lot of time, like you would be moving from one place to another and searching for that. So this is what financial market facilitates. It provides you a platform. Platform necessarily doesn't mean the physical location. It could be an online process also. So it is providing you a platform to make the exchange processes, and that exchange process too with various financial assets. So whether you are interested in investing in bonds, whether you are interested in investing in commodity or currencies or equity, whatever is there. So you can be a part of this financial market. It acts as a pool between savers, investors and borrowers. Just take an example of bank. What does the bank do? Bank takes your money because you are having extra of savings. So you deposit that into bank. What does bank do then? It keeps certain percentage of amount as a cash reserve ratio, which is mandatory by the RBI. Rest of the amount it would invest. It would invest somewhere in the corporates, the other financial institutions, or to other commercial banks. From there, it would earn some interest rates. And who are that who are taking the money? They are termed as the borrowers. They would act as a borrowers at that particular period of time. They would be paying certain interest rate on that. And this interest rate would be again paid to the customers who had deposited their money into the banks. Obviously, there would be differences in the margins, because that is what the income for various parties involved in that market. So thus it is acting as a pool between savers, investors and borrowers. It involves various parties like governments, banks, financial institutions, insurance companies, mutual funds, corporates, all the parties. All the parties together forms this financial market because they are involved in the exchange process of the financial assets. Now let us see the types of financial market. There are many financial markets, but we would be talking some of the most important markets of finance, that is the money market, the capital market, the forex market, the derivatives market, and the commodity market. In this video, I would be talking about the money market in details. For rest of the markets like the capital, forex, derivatives, and commodity, you can keep a track on my upcoming video. I'm very sure you would be able to understand it in a detailed way. So what does the money market means? Money market actually facilitates the trading of financial assets with short-term maturities. Like you wanted to invest or you wanted to buy the assets for a shorter period of time, maybe from 1 day to 1 year, something in between that. So money market would help you trading this way. It would help you in maintaining a liquidity to your asset because it is for a shorter time period. So whenever you are in requirement of the cash or whenever you are in requirement for the fund, you can just sell that asset and get that amount instantly. So money market helps in that. Capital market is trading in long-term securities for a longer time period, which is further divided into stock market and bond market, where stock market helps you in dealing with equity trading. As you know, equity involves higher risk and thus give you higher returns, while the bond market, it deals with bond trading, where it involves a moderately lower risk than equity, and it gives you a lower return than the equity market. Then there is forex market. The forex markets helps you in making the exchange process, the buying and selling and speculating on currencies. As you know, the value of currencies also keeps on fluctuating. So you can trade on that. You can trade on currencies to gain some profit out of there. Now, forex trading is generally done in currency pairs like US dollar and Indian rupee or euro and Indian rupee. You can exchange in that process. You are paying some amount of Indian rupee to gain some US dollars. And then you are speculating on the value of that dollar to get increased after a certain period of time. This is what forex market facilitates. Derivatives market is the financial market for derivatives. Various future contracts are involved over there. Like in today's time period, you are making an agreement to purchase an asset with an expectation that the value of it would rise in a certain period of time in future. Whether the value would rise or would fall, it would depend totally upon you because you are making contract at this period of time. So this is what derivatives market is. It derives its value from the underlying assets. It could be anything. It could be equity, it could be currency, it could be any commodity also, or a simple negotiable bills also. The commodity market. The commodity market helps you trading in primary products like the agricultural products, the gold, mines, oil. You know, the value of oils, mines, and golds is. These values could make you very profitable if you are good in speculating on these values. So commodity market helps you in facilitating and exchanging with these products. Let's go to money market and talk something about that. As I already told, money market helps you in trading in financial assets with short-term maturity period, which lies up to 1 year. The regulator of money market in India is Reserve Bank of India. Government was talking to provide this control to SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India, which is right now the regulator of capital market. But let's see what happens. Right now the regulator is, the control is in the hand of RBI. The money market helps industries secure short-term loans to meet their working capital requirement through the short-term finance bills or commercial papers. It helps in earning income along with liquidity maintenance. So yeah, when you are in need of instant fund, when the banks, when the corporates are in need of instant fund to meet the requirements of their working capital, to meet various other requirements, what they do? They trade in money market because the maturity period is less. You can instantly get the money. You can get the money back. You can get the money back with a rise rate of interest within few days or few months or up to 1 year, whatever the time period is there, whatever the requirement you are having, depending on that. It helps in earning income along with liquidity maintenance. Talking about various instruments of money market, let's see what call money is. So call money is a method by which commercial banks borrow from each other to maintain the cash reserve ratio fixed by ratio. And the interest rate paid on call money is termed as call rate. Recent call rate is between 6.5 to 7%. So call money is basically the trading or exchange process being facilitated in two of the commercial banks, where one bank is in need of the funds while the other bank is ready to give that funds but will be charging certain interest rate from the other bank. So this is what happens. If you are in a certain, if you are getting short as a fund, you are in certain need to maintain your obligations, then what you would do, you would go to another bank and you would ask for that amount of fund. And if the bank is ready to give you that fund, they would be charging certain interest rate. That is what we call the call rate. And the recent call rate is between 6.5 to 7%. Now, this call money maturity is very shorter. It is for 1 to 2 days. So you can think of it like it's an urgent requirement or an urgent requirement of instant fund by the bank, which is met by the another bank. Talking about the treasury bill, it is issued by RBI on behalf of the government to cover the deficit balance or to control the money supply in the market. So government could also go in deficit budget. As you know, the expenditure, various expenditures are budgeted, and then there is amount which government is actually having, the revenue, which is generated through tax and other sources. Now, if the government is going out of the budget and it wants to meet its expenditure, what it would do? It would try to get money out of it would try to make money out of there. So it would be issuing certain bills, which is known as treasury bills. It is also done to control the money supply in the market. If the government feels like a lot of money supply is being done in the market, which is giving a rise to the inflation, it would try to control that money supply from the market. For this reason, it would provide certain treasury bills, T-bills, which would be bought by various institutions, the public, and that would help in controlling the money supply in the market, because they would be providing their money to the government by purchasing those bills. What is the feature of this? It is issued at discount and repayable at par value. So just think of it like the value is 500. The value of the bill is 500. Now you would be paying only say 450 for that bill, and after the maturity period you would be getting 500. So it is being issued at a discounted value and you would be getting the actual value at the maturity. For this reason, it is also referred as zero coupon bond. It is negotiable and freely transferable. So you can transfer your T-bills and the value would remain same. You can then sell it and you can then redeem it and get the amount of money. It is generally issued in three types, that is 91 days, 182 days and 364 days till T-bills. These days are showing the maturity period. You can have the maturity period of 91, 182 or 364 days depending upon your requirement. And then the return which you actually get is about 6 to 7% from these T-bills. Coming to the commercial papers, it is an unsecured promissory note. Unsecured because it is issued by corporates to generate fund. Now, corporates are in requirement of fund to meet their investing activities, to meet their projects in which they thought of investing, but they are running out of the budget. What they would do, they would issue commercial papers with a maturity period of up to 12 months. They can do it either directly or also through the banks. What happens, because it is issued by the corporates and it is a little riskier because it is for a shorter time period, so generally the public don't go for commercial papers. Most of the banks and financial institutions purchase these promissory notes and provide funds. What corporations do in return, they provide certain interest rate to the banks for providing funds when it was required. Then there is certificate of deposits. Banks issue these certificates or document of title to the depositors who deposit their money for longer period of time. And these are mostly the companies. Now again, this transaction is between the banks and the corporates. There are corporates who are having an extra surplus fund and they wanted to invest it into the bank to keep that fund saved, to keep that fund as a deposit. What bank in return would give, it would provide a certificate of deposit. That certificate would provide the enlightenment, that certificate would provide the entitlement to the banks that they have made that deposit and they would be getting certain return out of it. Normally, it is issued in multiples of 1 lakhs and the maturity period lies up to 12 months. So guys, in this video, we covered about the financial market, then the various types of financial market, then we looked at money market in details and various instruments of the money market. I hope you liked the video and were able to understand whatever I told about these instruments, whatever I told about the overall financial market. If you're having any doubt or any query, you can comment and you can ask me about that. You can even suggest me for better videos. You can even suggest me for videos on another topics. I would look forward for it. Thank you so much for watching. Do like, subscribe, and share my channel.